Limiting nitrates in water is a complicated problem because of the prevalence of nitrogen in the environment. Nitrogen is the most abundant gas in the atmosphere and a major component of protein and other organic molecules. Most forms of nitrogen convert to nitrate, its negatively charged ion, through a natural process in the soil. Therefore, managing nitrates in water is not as simple as reducing N fertilizer rates. There are three main ways that nitrates move to surface waters: overland runoff, shallow groundwater flow, or artificial drainage. Studies have shown that very little nitrate moves via runoff because water needs to percolate through the soil to move nitrates. Movement through drainage systems and shallow groundwater are very similar with respect to water quality, but water moves much faster through a drainage system. The University of Minnesota developed drainage plots near Waseca and Lamberton in the mid-1970s. This research has been used to craft the university's nutrient management best management practices and shape our thoughts on water quality. Let's look at nitrogen fertilizer application timing from a crop rotation study on those drainage plots at Waseca. You can see that nitrate loss is similar between spring application and fall application using a nitrification inhibitor. However, yields are higher with a spring application. This is likely because some of the fall applied N is lost through denitrification to the atmosphere. This study also shows that applying above recommended rates of fall N can increase yield, but still isn't as good as the spring applied BMP rate. The higher rate of fall applied nitrogen results in significant N loss. Additionally, if we look at the soybean year and corn that received no N fertilizer, losses are still in the neighborhood of 10 pounds per acre, even though no fertilizer was applied. This is because organic matter mineralizes and releases nitrogen in the soil. Plants do a good job of scavenging this nitrogen, but annual crops such as corn and soybean typically reach maturity in early September, while the soil usually doesn't cool down enough to stop mineralization until late October. This allows nitrate to accumulate in the soil profile, making it subject to loss before next year's crop begins to grow. Also note that when the BMP rate was applied, the N loss numbers go up, but are still only slightly higher than when no N was applied. This means that applying less than the BMP N rate only has a minimal impact on water quality while severely affecting productivity and profitability. As further evidence, when a perennial plant was present on the drainage plots at Lamberton, losses go to nearly zero. This indicates that if there is a living plant to take up late season mineralized N, nitrates may be kept out of surface water. This is one reason why there is a push to incorporate cover crops into production systems. In conclusion, eliminating nitrogen fertilizer from our crop production systems is not the solution to water quality issues, but avoiding overapplication of N can have a positive impact on water quality. Proper nitrogen fertilizer management is important, but other strategies will be necessary to meet water quality goals. Sign up for the Minnesota Crop News daily or weekly email newsletter to stay up to date on the latest University of Minnesota agronomic research, recommendations, events, and more.